So we're going to talk about kind of a part of rigs, actually, is a hair part of the rig. Obviously, long ago, people just side hooked baits on, didn't they? Hook baits, but the hair rig was a huge step forward in carp rig mechanics. But you can take it a bit further than that. Some people fish a real short hair and other people use a long one, don't they? I mean, what do you do in your fishing?
I think genuinely, I use short hairs probably 90% of the time because I'm using rigs like the Bivvy rig or the basic complicated. And I think it also, you need to look at sort of the baiting aspect.
The bait that you're using, yeah.
Because you know, so many people now spod, and spodding's got really good, and the food you can put into a spod mix, ready to go.
Small particles, yeah.
It's all small particle, and what you're training the fish to do is to stay, you know, literally sat on the bottom and just feeding, you know, especially if they've got extruded males, they're
not moving their head very much at all,
no.
Are they? Yeah.
So what you want is literally a short rig with a short hair.
Yep, I agree.
You know, because if you're fishing a long hair, they'll suck at that and moving on to the next bit, and it will literally blow back out the mouth.
Without you coming tight to the lead and...
Yeah, yeah. So, I mean, something in that situation where you're, you know, if you've got like a little situation like that, you've got particle, hemp,
pellet,
snail, something like that, which is almost what you said, that is almost like a side hook boilie,
yeah.
But it's just a little bit more modern than the side hooks, you know, so you've actually got the whole shape of the hook exposed, and you know, they're coming in and that's
turning,
it doesn't turn, but the whole idea
it's catching hold,
the whole
it?
Idea yeah. of this little rig is that it's the hook is sat right next to the boilie, so you know, if you're on a short rig, they're moving, then they're hardly moving, so they're blown in and out.
That's it.
With a sharp point, you're going to get a hook hold, and then the lead does the rest.
That's right. Yeah.
You know, so that's what I would use. You know, in a spotting situation,
small type,
or even underneath snags, because it's the same with snags. You know, they're literally patrolling the edges, coming out, backing. Mm-hmm. So I want a hook that's right next to the boilie. Yep. But if I was fishing a scattering of boilies.
Where you might have put it out with a throwing stick or a catapult.
No spod whatsoever.
That's it, yep.
I would use a slightly longer hair.
Sure.
Because the fish are coming in, picking it up, taking the bait, eating it, moving on to the next one, trying to find, you know, and if there's a few fish there, it gets more competitive.
Yeah.
So it's, you know, it's all about how many fish are in a lake. I mean, I've done this is a rig I used sort of early 90s. That's what I would deem a long hair.
Yeah.
Some people would use them that long.
Sure.
Because what you've got to remember, the mechanics of a carp, you've got the mouth, the lips, and then the teeth, especially on, let's say, a 30-pound carp, are 6 inches back from the mouth.
Yeah.
So that is that's the target object to get to the back of the mouth. So people would use a much longer hair.
Sure.
Because they know. But for me, just mechanically, if they suck that in, that could hit that,
exactly.
Eject it.
Yep.
So what I used to use, I use this little rig, and if you notice there, Myles,
that slides on up. Yeah.
It's a slide. It's just a slide in hair.
Yep.
So I've taken it through the front part of the eye,
and it goes out that way. Yep.
Yeah. So PVA that up.
Okay. And that's tied there, or some kind of sliding mechanism up there.
I mean, I literally knocked this one up just for this.
Yeah.
If I was fishing, you know, I would fish in a normal situation. I'd probably put a little ring on there now.
Yeah, one of the 1 or 2 mil type rings.
Yeah, just
tiny
the 1 mil.
Yeah,
just
right.
Literally a tiny little ring, and because that's on the power link fluorocarbon, that will slide down very easy. But as you can see, it slides down anyway.
Sure, yeah.
So the fish will suck that in. Just taking that a step further, you could, with a tiny piece of sliver of foam, counterbalance the hook.
Of course, yeah, yeah. So you see how that mechanic will work, yeah.
The fish would suck that whole thing in, blow it, and then the hair would separate.
Sure.
Now that's a complete headache for a carp. You know, so that's just one way. Because if I was fishing a hair like that, I'd actually worry that would tangle.
Me too,
even,
yeah.
Even
with a bit of foam, it would still,
I like to be, you know, if I've got a bait out there for 24 hours, hopefully you haven't.
It's got to be right, yeah.
It's got
to
be right. So that, for me, fishing a long hair would have to be extended up, and it catches a lot of fish. I used it at Broadlands back in the winter. I was fishing it in solid bags.
Yep.
And
there you don't have the worry of tangling anything.
No,
but
just putting it in the bag like that, PVA'd it up, and just in a, you know, a little small solid bag.
Yep.
And it was nailing so many fish
yeah,
when
yeah.
other rigs weren't. So it's, you know, it's worth thinking about that, especially in winter time, because the carp's metabolism is so much slower.
That's right, they're not feeding so much.
Yeah.
They don't make so many mistakes because they're you won't have a competitive feed.
And they're only feeding for an hour or two, possibly a day.
Yeah.
So, you know, that's when you really need to think about the rigs. And you know, but it pays to, you know, if you're fishing for big fish, you can get away with a longer hair. Smaller fish, they'll do you because they'll pick it up and they're on to the next one and they're too scatty, like, you know, but bigger fish is much slower movement. So you can get away with a rig like that where the mechanics will work against a big fish. So that's, you know, that's my take on it. What's your take?
Well, no, I mean, I use a rig that incorporates mono is the main part of it, and I use a braided hair, and I feel that not for every rig, obviously, but when I'm boily fishing particularly, and I like that supple braid for the hair. It allows the hook to separate from the boily. Mm. I feel as it's going in and moving as the fish comes tight. But like you, when I'm fishing boilies that aren't spotted, it's just out with a stick and they're scattered around, I like that fish to move its head so that it's you know, it's going to come tight to the lead that then gets that hook in. And then agree, when if you're using pellet spod mix, nice short length, short hair, you know, pretty much the same. There are so many rigs out there, but they come down to common factors, you know, short hair, short rig when you're using spod mix, boilies, nice longer rig, and so on. I agree. But it's a great looking rig. But I do hear a lot of people say, oh, I just use a couple of rigs or one rig. That's the only rig I use, mate. It's the only thing I need. And I don't agree. I think you need to have a few tricks up your sleeve, don't you?
Well, I think so. I mean, I've spent my whole life messing around with rigs
since
the 80s. Yeah, it's a
part of the enjoyment.
It's a hobby. It's a hobby for me, doing the rig side of it. But like you say, I mean, I recall back on the welly days.
Mm.
Didn't you have a big fish, long hair, size 10 hook?
I use size 10 hook all the time anyway, so, on there, yeah.
I think that's, you know, I think that's a key point, is that if you are going to use a long hair and you want it to travel inside the mat, you need a smaller hook.
I think so,
because there's no point having a big long hair and then a heavy hook, because they'll mark that as a dodgy rig, and
exactly. I was using quite a big bait or double 15s, double 16s, that sort of size bait with a size 10 hook.
But you can get away with that because you've got that separation from the bait. So.
Exactly. So, yeah, a little bit of thought into rigs. The bait you're using definitely dictates the kind of rig that you ought to be tying up. So a little bit of thought and you'll catch some more fish.